I'm Sam Sheridan from Sheridan Computers, and today I'm going to go through how to install Bitwarden as a self-hosted solution. I got the idea from this from one of Tom Lawrence's videos. He did a review on Bitwarden, and it's been fully code audited, and it's the fact that you're able to host it on premises, so I don't need to allow internet access to my password manager. It just makes me very interested and I want to try it. So we're going to go ahead and do that. I am doing this on Centos 8. If you're unfamiliar of how to install Centos 8, I have a video on that. I'll leave a link at the end of this video. It does need Docker because we're deploying Docker containers. So if you're unfamiliar with how to install Docker, I've also done a video on installing Docker on Centos 8. So you should be good to go from that standpoint. So if we switch over. So this is a fresh installation of Centos, carried on basically from where I did the videos on installation and Docker installation. So if we head over to github.com/bitwarden/server, we scroll down, we have the Docker deployment instructions. So we're going to go ahead and follow these. Now looking at the deployment instructions, I can understand why Tom didn't want to do a video on it or didn't feel it was necessary. It's like literally three lines of code that you've got to copy and paste here. So let me go ahead and copy that. So we have our Bitwarden installation script. The commands are install and start. So let's go ahead and do the install. Enter the domain name for your Bitwarden instance. At this point, I'm just going to enter an IP address. Now, according to the videos that Tom did, he mentioned that if you don't have a valid certificate, the desktop application and the mobile applications won't connect. They'll just refuse. I have read up on it, and there are some ways around it by installing the certificates on your Android devices. It's a pain in the ass to do. So for this, it suggests installing it on, like, this is bitwarden.example.com. If you installed it on bitwarden.yourdomain.com, as long as the DNS resolves locally, you know, you can buy a certificate and install a certificate, and that'll get around any issues that you've got connecting. It doesn't need to be resolvable from the internet as long as it resolves locally. And then if you're going to connect over a VPN or anything from your phone, you'll be fine. So I'm just going to go ahead and enter an IP address for this. Do you want to use Let's Encrypt? Nope. No inbound internet access to this machine, which is the purpose of the install. Enter the installation ID. So we need an installation ID, and we get that from this address, apparently. So go over and do that. Host installation ID, use the form below. You should use a unique ID and key for each Bitwarden installation. I will hide that. So we've got our installation ID. Just go ahead, paste that in. Enter the installation key. Do you have an SSL certificate to use? No. Do you want to generate a self-signed certificate? Yes. And then the installation is complete. So it does say if you need to make any additional configuration changes, you can modify the settings and then run bitwarden.sh rebuild or update. So let's just start it, see if it works. So the initial download of all the components took around 5 minutes there. I'll speed that part of the video up so you don't have to sit there for 5 minutes watching it download. Okay, it says Bitwarden is up and running. So it's visit and it's give us the address that we set up initially. Stick around, don't run off. There are still some changes that you need to make to the configuration files. I'm just going to log in and make sure it works and everything, but stick around for the changes. That's a good sign. And we have a login, so let's go ahead and create an account. Password in for this. Weak password. Yes, that's fine. It's a demo. Okay, your account has been created. You may now log in. Right, so we're in and we have our instance up and running. So like I said, there's a couple of changes you're going to need to make to the configuration files. That is verify your account's email address to unlock access to all features. We can't verify the email's not going to work basically because we've not set up the email servers. So we need to go ahead and do that. So we have a BW data directory. Bitwarden keeps all its data separate from the installation file, so when you need to back up, that's what you need to back up. So if we log in there, go into EMV, and there's this file here, globaloveride.env, which is the one that we want to edit. So vi globaloveride.env. Now in here we have all the settings that we're going to need to modify, and the main ones that we're going to need to modify are the from email address. So you're going to want to set the email address up that's being sent from. So bitwarden@example.com. Obviously this needs to be valid. You're going to need to set your SMTP host, mymailhost.example.com. Port, whether you're using SSL or not, I'd strongly advise you to use SSL. Your username. And so once we've done that, we can go ahead and save the file. Head back into our home directory. So I obviously paused the video there while I put some proper details in there. So let's go ahead and rebuild. So you'll notice when I did the rebuild process, it says stopping Bitwarden, Nginx, admin service and stuff, but it's removed the data, rebuilt it, but it hasn't started the service, so you're going to need to restart it. So Bitwarden is up and running again. At this stage, it's worth remembering when you reboot, it's not going to start itself. You're going to want to create some startup scripts for that. You can put it in the reboot cron tab or create a systemd service, whichever way you're going to do it. Just keep that in mind that when you do a rebuild, it stops all the services. You have to start them yourself. If you reboot the machine, power it off, turn it back on, you're going to have to start the Bitwarden server again. So if we head back over, I do send email. Check your email for a verification link. So let me quickly go ahead and do that. So I've verified the email address so we can log back in again. And that's it, basically. To access the admin panel, this is another reason that you need the email fully working, because in order to access the admin panel, when we go to the admin URL, which is just /admin at the end, it will ask you to put your email address in. So if a valid admin user has been specified with this email address, we've sent you a link to log in. So you can specify as many admins as you want. Again, that's done in the this global settings file at the bottom. So you can put your admins in here. So let me go ahead and get that and log in. And so we're logged in as admin. So we can see the latest server version and the current installed version. You can see your mail settings, installation ID, the users, organizations, and a link to the docs. That is pretty much it for this demo. You're fully up and working, fully up and running. It works fine. As I say, I'm not actually going to do any tutorials on how to use Bitwarden itself. Tom Lawrence has done these, so I'll leave a link below to the reviews that Tom Lawrence did, which will give you a good walkthrough on how to get started. It's just, as I say, there's no point in me doing the same thing over and over again. If you'd like to hire us, head over to our website at sheridan.co.uk, fill out the contact form, leave some details on what you're looking for, and we'll see if we can help you. If you like this video, please go ahead and press the like button and consider subscribing to the channel. It does help us a lot. Thank you.